Hi, my name is Megan McNish, and I'm a preservation planner with the City of Columbia. Today, we're going to be talking a little bit about the history of the Granby Architectural Conservation District. So some important dates for the history of the Granby Mill Village. Between 1896 and 1897, the Granby Mill was constructed. And in 1897, W.B. Smith Whaley, who was the owner of the mill, began to build housing for the workers that would be coming from other areas in South Carolina to Columbia to work in these mills. At first, they built about 55 houses, but in 1899, an additional 60 houses were constructed to house these mill workers. In 1916, W.B. Smith Whaley and company sold both the Granby and Olympia mills to the Pacific Mills Company. With the sale of both of those mills, all of the associated housing in the Granby area also went to the Pacific Mill Company. Pacific Mills constructed several additional houses in the district, but by the time they purchased the area, most of the lots within the district had been already built upon. So there was a small amount of infill housing added after 1916. In 1939, as costs associated with these structures began to increase, the Pacific Mill Company began to sell off the houses that they owned in the Granby area to the people that actually lived in them. Prior to that, they had been rented. And with the sale of the houses to individual property owners, they began to make some minor changes to the houses to make them distinctive and make them their own. So it's around that time that we see some minor changes to things like porch supports and columns, front stairs, occasionally changing out windows, and siding, all sorts of little changes that helped make these houses more distinctive for those that lived in them. These are changes that are really important to telling the story of the area, though. So, important as a part of Granby's history. Fast forward to 1993, the Granby Mill Village was listed in the National Register of Historic Places. And in 2010, the area was locally designated as an architectural conservation district. So Granby is a fairly unique area within Columbia. Like other mill districts throughout the Southeast, it's got a very cohesive streetscape. There are four historic house types located within the district. There is the Type A saltbox style house, the Type B gable houses, Type C supervisor houses, and then the bungalows. And we'll run through what each of those look like in just a moment here. In addition to the residential structures located within the district, there were also several historic commercial buildings as well, including an office building across the street from the Granby Mill and a pharmacy building that's since been demolished. So the first of the historic house types is the Type A saltbox style house. This is the most common house type within the district. It's pervasive throughout the area. These structures were historically duplexes and are characterized by their two front doors and saltbox-shaped roof. The second house type within the district is the Type B gable house. These are found predominantly on Whaley Street between Gist and Williams Streets, and they were also historically duplex structures and had those two front doors that you find on the Type A houses. Finally, the Type C supervisor houses. These are found on Whaley Street between Hugie and the edge of the district, which is about where 612 Whaley Street is. These were historically single family residences. And like all of the other house types we've already talked about, they also had two front doors, except in this case, one is on the first floor and one is on the second floor on that balcony level. As the name implies, these houses were used to house supervisors for the mills, those in upper level management. So those first three house types that I just mentioned, the Type A saltbox style house, the Type B gable houses, and the Type C supervisor houses were all constructed while W.B. Smith Whaley owned both the Granby and Olympia mills. So these were in the first phase of development for the Granby district. The last historic house type that we find within the Granby area are the bungalows. These are found on Church, Hugie, and Tryon Streets, on the last lots to be developed closest to the mills. These were like the Type C supervisor houses. These were historically single family residences. And one of the things that makes these structures so unique is their column design. Many of those columns were lost, but one house on Church Street recently had those columns restored. So that is a brief overview of the Granby Architectural Conservation District. I hope this was informative. And should you have any questions about Granby or any of the historic districts located within the city of Columbia, please feel free to email us at preservation@columbiasc.gov. Thank you.